Soto in complete control at the moment. I think Gunn is stumped as to what to do here. What do you think, Pat?
Well, so far he's trying every which way to try to get out of this arm lock, and I haven't been able to do anything.
I think he's just trying to hold on for dear life. Oh, yeah! My goodness!
Well, Miss, I tell you what, you threw a beautiful drop kick the way he does it. You don't need to throw another one. Really, really well executed.
Very seldom does one wrestler defeat another by just the use of a drop kick. Normally there's something else after that, but Soto's drop kick is so devastating, he almost took the head off of Irish Terry Gunn. Look at the official time.
It is time. 7 minutes
and 36 seconds on the winner, Roberto Soto. Roberto Soto victorious. We have the slow motion action. No? All right, we'll take a look at it now. Setting his man up, Soto, who really can deliver a classic drop kick. Take a look at this now. Plants his feet right up and right against the front of the jaw. Nobody that I have seen does it quite as well as Roberto Soto. Look at this young man hooking the knee there as if he needed it just for additional leverage. For insurance, Roberto Soto victorious, and will return with the likes of the magnificent Morocco, Killer Khan, Dominic Zanucci, Tony Garea, and Rick Martel, Greg Valentine, and a whole lot more. Stay with us. Lots more wrestling action headed up here on Championship Wrestling. Woody Blassie on his way tomorrow night to the Nassau County Veterans Memorial Coliseum of Long Island, whereby Mr. Blassie represents George the Animal of Steele, who will lock up with Pat Patterson in what is likely to be a real Donnybrook.
I heard a previous interview Pat Patterson made, said I'm sending my man, Incredible Animal, George Steele after him. That's right. Anytime my men wrestle somebody, I tell them, destroy him. Everybody out there in TV land see what George Animal Steel did to wrestle that geek in the ring before. Ripped his shoulder out, broke the elbow, and still continued to pound the man. The man will stop at nothing until he destroys you. And Patterson, nothing suits me better than to have you destroyed. Patterson, George. Patterson. Patterson.
Announcer! Our ladies and gentlemen, the next contest is a non-title bout. It is set for one fall of a 10-minute time limit. But first I want to introduce the manager. Here he is, the manager of champions, the Grand Wizard of Wrestling. On this corner of my right, from New York City, weighing 245 pounds, here is Steve Mitchell. And from Sunset Beach, a weighing 247 pounds, ladies and gentlemen, here is the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, the magnificent Morocco.
Morocco facing about, getting ready for his match with Pete Mitchell. But then after this, Pete, well, I'm sure Mr. Morocco will take exception to that sign, and certainly take exception to remarks that the fans are likely to make at some time or another during this match. First in for action to commence.
Focus on this commercial break. On Tuesday night, August the 18th, 1 week from this Tuesday night, shall we say, it's in Vernon, New Jersey, the very first appearance of professional wrestling at the Vernon Valley Township High School in Vernon, New Jersey on August 18th. where you'll see the likes of King Kong Maka, who is rougher and tougher as ever, according to Captain Louis Albano, as well Dominic DiNucci on the card, and the popular Pedro Morales, who sees action in the main event, the 18th of August, a Tuesday night in Vernon, New Jersey.
Something he does it well. He is a champion right now, and believe me, and when I say that, Vince, this guy could probably soon, if he has the chance or the opportunity, become the world's champion. He could be one of them.
Oh, he has that caliber. There's no doubt about that. He could go all the way. You'll see so many different moves, so many different maneuvers by Magnificent Morocco. In this instance, Morocco is truly magnificent. In some instances, he is certainly short of the mark.
If you see that reverse pile driver, that alone is a stunt. Triple the wrestler.
Beach bomb, beach bomb, listen to this. Oh, wow. The announcement, we shall have some slow motion action.
It is time, 2 minutes and 14 seconds in the winner, the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, the Magnificent Morocco.
The Magnificent Morocco chalks up yet another victory, and he is really going places in the World Wrestling Federation. And now let's go back down to slow motion. Morocco doing what he does best. Pat's picking up here with a suplex.
Look at this, man. This is a reverse pile driver that he uses so well. That alone can break somebody's neck. Look at that. And Morocco right there is not satisfied, really taking his time. You know what? His opponent will not go anywhere. Climbing up the top rope. Now, Morocco's a big man, 260, 265 pounds. And look at it, looking at everybody, really cocky coming down. Full blast. I'm telling you, that Morocco is something else.
Well, now we've got a humdinger revenge coming up now. Dominic DiNucci against Killer Khan.
Our ladies and gentlemen, in this contest, is scheduled for one fall for the 10-minute time limit. But first, the winner to the best manager of the fashion trade of wrestling, it is Fred Balassi. And in the corner of my right, from Venice, Italy, weighing 236 pounds, here is Dominic DiNucci. And in the corner of my left, from Mongolia, weighing 292 pounds, it is Killer Khan.
Killer Khan against Dominic DiNucci, a very interesting match indeed. Fred Lasse certainly is taking his time and taking his exit. Killer Khan, man who broke Rick McGraw's neck, broke Andre the Giant's ankle. You wonder when his reign of terror will end, Pat Patterson.
I tell you, this man has got a reputation right now. He is in demand everywhere around the world. No one has ever been able to put Andre the Giant in a hospital, and this man has got it.
Khan working Dominic over in the corner. Lifshine, a gifted athlete, 300-pounder with extraordinary agility. Has a sumo background, the martial arts background, and a great wrestler as well. He's a giant in his own right at 6'6 and about a little better than 300.
Yes, Vince, you know, he's in tremendous condition. He won't let up DiNucci because they know DiNucci's able to really take care of himself, and he won't let up on Dominic.
Shot there to the throat area. DiNucci's hanging on. Khan trying to kick him off the rope. He'll fall right on his head on the concrete floor.
Dominic is really hanging on to that rope. If he lets go, he'll go right on his head. As you said, Ben, very, very dangerous position to be in.
Ooh, wow.
I was in the room for 3 minutes. because I died. I tell you, Tom, I'm going to try against you anytime you want, any way you want. They're going to fuck me up in the red car and the fire any way you want. Anytime you want. I got enough of that. I'm tired of that now. You know, John, I just want you to come in the that place. Don't even in the place. This is my side in the airway. We got a big fight everywhere today. I got fighting everywhere. Get a car, do it right about step in the front of me, because I'm going to fight with you everywhere you want. I'll be on this thing. I think I'm going to go this for you.
I agree. I understand.
The thing could be a coming thing. I can give you a prayer, but ask you for my prayer. If you're into genetic equipment, you're also my friend, my mom did it, but crush it up on this way.
Well, we can't reach out to this man, but he said, and I'm sure that I'll be fully upset when he wants to live on. That's all the time we have.
It's true. I just want to do it. Something for myself to get myself bothered. What's this for you people to get you out of here? I'm going to do it, folks.
Scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit introducing